Hello everyone, welcome to all in this video. Today we are going to discuss the BSc 3 Electronics Group C practical, the logical operation of 8051 microcontroller. The aim of this practical is to study of logical operation of 8051 microcontroller using embedded C. Here we have used Keel software. The flowchart of logical AND operation of 8051 is shown on the screen. Now, I will explain you the program flowchart and embedded C code of logical operation. Initially, include the header file, then start the program, then define the variable. Here, I have defined A and B variable. Assign the value of variables, then perform the operation and store the result on any location or port and then keep it in loop. This is the embedded C code of logical AND operation. Initially, include the header file using instruction hash include reg51.h. Then start the program using instruction void main, then open curly bracket, then assign the variable. Here we have assigned variable A and B. Then assign the value of variables. A is equal to 0x02, which is the hexadecimal value. Similarly, assign the value of B variable. Here I have assigned 0x03. After operation of logical AND, the result sent to port P0 logical OR operation. As like previous one, here again include header file, start program, define variable, then assign the value of variables and then perform the operation and store a result into particular port. Here we have used port 1. The embedded C code of logical OR operation is shown on the screen. Similar to previous one, include the header file, then start program, then assign the variable using instruction unassigned char A, B, then assign the value of A and B, then send the result to port P1. The third logical operation of 8051 is XOR. The flowchart of XOR is shown on the screen, and this is the program of logical XOR operation. Here the result is sent to port P2 after performing the operation of logical XOR. This is the right shift operation program flowchart. Here embedded C program of right shift operation. Similarly, we will study the left shift operation, bit addressing operation of 8051. Now I will explain you how to use Keel software for 8051 programming. Initially, double click on Keel icon, then open it. For writing of 8051 program, the procedure of Keel is divided into four parts. First one, making the new project. Second one, addition of source file and code writing. Third one, debugging program. And last one, making the hex file. For making the new project, click on project, then click on new project. Now here it opens new window. Create new project. Write the project name. I am writing the project name Logical Operation and then save it. Now again open new window, select a device for target 1. These are the companies of 8051 ICs, but here I have select Atmel IC, IC8089S52, and then click on OK. The new window is again open Micro version 3, and here the message copy standard 8051 startup code to project folder and add file to project. Click on yes, then click on no. For addition of source file and code writing, click on file, then click on new. Now here is the open new window, text 1. In this window, write the program. Now I have written the program for logical AND operation. After writing of program, click on file and again click on save as. I am writing logical AND. .c means we have written program in embedded C, and then click on save. Then right click on source group 1 and then click on add file to group source group 1. Our program is logical AND dot C. Then click on logical AND dot C, and then after that click on translate current file, then click on build target, then click on rebuild all target files. Here our program error is 0 and warning is also 0. Our third stage is debugging the program. For debugging, click on debug and then click on start/stop debug session. Click on OK. After that, click on peripheral and take port P0. Result of logical AND operation is sent to port P0. Then we can run program stepwise also. Here click on run. Now our answer is 0x02. Then again click on debug and again click on start/stop debug session. Our fourth part is making the hex file. For making the hex file, right click on target 1, then click on option for target 1. Here the click on output and click on create hex file. Then click on OK. Again click on translate current file, build target and rebuild all target files. Here our hex file is created and its name is logical operation. Our next program is logical OR operation. Here remove this file S and then copy the logical OR operation code and paste here. You can write using keyboard and then again file save as logical OR.c. Okay. Add this file into source group. Here right click on source group 1 and then click on add file to source group 1. Search our logical OR operation file and here add and then close. Click on translate current file, build target, then rebuild all target, then debug, start stop debugging, press F5, we require port 1, this is our answer 0x03, means A is equal to 0x01, B is equal to 0x03, after logical OR operation P1 is equal to 0x03. The next program is logical XOR operation. Initially remove this source file, right click on this source file and then remove file logical OR.c. Then write the logical XOR operation code, then save it, save as logical XOR dot C save, then right click on source group 1 and add this file. Search the file here. This is the logical xr.c file. Then click on add and then close. After that, click on translate current file, build target and rebuild all target files. Here error is 0 and warning is 0. Then click on debug, start stop debugging, then OK. We require port P2. Go to peripheral and IO port and then port P2. Press F5. Here the output of XOR operation is 0x03, means the variable A is equal to 0x05, then variable B is equal to 0x06. After XOR operation, result is sent to port P2, which is 0x02. Our next program is right shift operation. Here, write program for right shift operation, then save it. Logical right shift dot C, save. Then right click on source group 1, add logical right shift operation, then click on add, then close, then click on translate current file, click on build target, click on rebuild all target files, then debug, start stop session. We go through stepwise now. Here, after first step, accumulator is equal to 0x30, means its binary data is 00110000. Then second step, this data is shifted right 4 times, means its output is here 00000011, which is 0x03 in hexadecimal. After that, it shifted again one time. In this step, our P0 data is 00000001, means it is shifted one time. Our next logical operation is left shift operation. Write the program of left shift operation. This is the program of left shift operation. Initially, remove the source file, then save this source file, save as logical left shift dot C, then click on save, then add this file into source group 1 using right click, add this file here, search our file. This is our file logical left shift dot C, add this and then close. Then click on translate current file, build target, rebuild all target files. Then click on debug, start stop debug. Here we consider accumulator equal to 0x03. It is shifted left one time, again one time, then three time, then one time. We are going to stepwise. After first step, accumulator is equal to 0x03. 0x means which is a hexadecimal data. After second step, here P0 is equal to 0x06, means in binary 00000110. Then after next step, it is shifted left. After next step, again it shifted three times. Initially remove this file, is write program. This is the complement operation program. Then save it, give a name, logical complement dot C. Then click on save. Then add into source group 1. Search this file. This is our logical complement dot C file. Here add this and then close. Then click on translate current file. Then click on build target. Then click on rebuild all target files. Then debug, start stop debug. Here we consider a is equal to 0x02, b is equal to 0x03, and then our result a complement is sent to p0, b complement is sent to p1. Okay, we are going to stepwise. After first step, p0 is equal to 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 1, means in a hexadecimal 0xabd. Then after next state, b is complemented and sent to port p1, which is 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 0. Our next program is logical bit addressing. I have written the program of logical bit addressing. Initially save this file. Click on file, save as. Then click on logical bit addressing. Dot C, then click on save, then right click on source group 1, click on add file. Our program is logical bit addressing dot C, add this and close it. Then click on translate current file, then click on build target, and then click on rebuild all target files. Then click on debug, start / stop debug session, then click on OK. Here we assign A is equal to port P0.0 pin and B is equal to port 1.0 pin. Initially A is equal to 0 means P0.0 equal to 0. You can see here. After next step, A is equal to 1 means here this is 1. Then after next step, B is equal to 0. Here B means P1.0 is equal to 0. We can see here. Then carry is equal to 1. Means CY is equal to 1. Then RS 0 is equal to 0. Here RS 0, RS equal to 0. Then RS 1 is equal to 1. Means in binary this data is 1 0, which is equivalent to hexadecimal 2. Here RS equal to 2. Then CY equal to complement CY. Here CY is equal to 0. Thank you for watching my video.